Double Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed. Now when we're talking boxing, we can go up to the heavyweights because it's happening up there for a change. It's going on, it's going down in the heavyweight division. We know it. The whole year has been going on and back and forth with a lot of fights. The main characters in there, you know, the Anthony Joshua's of the world, the Deontay Wilders of the world. The Tyson Furies of the world is back in the mix. The Dillian Whites, Joseph Parkers. We got some things. And the boogeyman, Lewis, the real King Kong Ortiz, who ain't nobody trying to fight, right? So you have all those things going on. And it's good. It's good storylines. And there's things happening all the time, right? Took a couple of days off to see if anything, smoke's going to clear, something's going to happen, right? Because I didn't want it to feel like Domodamus in here. You know, it's like you're gloating. Because you've been right about everything, especially when it comes to Anthony Joshua, Deontay Wilder's negotiations. You're just right about everything, right? So it's a, you know, bam. People stop sick of you being right about that. So we got some other stuff going on. But before we go to that, we're going to go to some Anthony Joshua's fight against Alexander Povetkin. You know, that's going down September the 22nd. Now, you know, it's been overshadowed, whether we like it or not. It's been overshadowed by the Deontay Wilder-Tyson Fury fight. That doesn't even happen without even a date. That one could happen on November the 10th, 17th, or in December. Talking more about that. And that's a good thing, right? It's a good thing. You know, it's a lesson in humility. But, okay, you're talking about the Anthony Joshua-Alexander Povetkin fight. We know it's shady how it happened in the first place, right? Listen, I'm just got to be real with you. It was shady, right? The WBA does not try to enforce this fight when the other fight's basically signed. 8 hours later after the fight signed with Deontay Wilder, he signs for $15 million for that ridiculous contract. 8 hours later, all of a sudden, he has to fight Povetkin and sign it within 24 hours. And then 3 weeks later, that fight was signed. So all those things you see, it's glaring for people who just don't want to be blind. It shouldn't even be happening. But okay, he's a mandatory. Remember before we go there too, a mandatory is less, right, then the unification fight. That means that nobody would have enforced it, or it's the whole boxing world would have looked at the WBA, get the hell out of the way, and let these men unify so we can get undisputed champion. So we got the fight regardless of how, right, on the 22nd. Now, I don't know if the place is sold out or not, you know, and then they're going to make it even bigger for April 13th or whatever. All those things going down. Now, you know, it should be a good fight. People are saying that, you know, this is going to be a good fight. Don't sleep on Alexander Povetkin. And all those things, right? You know, and my point the whole time is this. Is me and Tony Bell, you see this the same way. I've said it a couple of months ago. I just want to repeat it. You know, a Povetkin off the juice, right? I don't think it's beating Joshua. A Povetkin off the juice, right? Because everything he's done up until now has been juice involved. You understand? So, you know, and maybe not David Price and maybe not Christian Hammer. But everything before that was juice involved. And before, by Carlos Takaman way back, a whole lot of juice involved. You know, legal juice, because Maldonium was all up in there. So that's giving you stamina. So, good fighter, technical and all that, but with no juice involved, I got to see it. I got to see him beat Anthony Joshua. I got Anthony Joshua. Now, for those who's like, man, that's a close fight. This is a close fight, man. I don't know what you're talking about. That's some hating or whatever. Well, I've always told you guys, when in doubt, check the odds, because odds makers don't have any color, any nationality, or any interest in anything except some money. You see? Therein lies the truth. Always. The odds. And if you see something ridiculous, like remember I saw that 8-1 Joseph Parker against Anthony Joshua, I had to jump on it. You know, I would have lost some money if I didn't hedge it, but 8-1 was ridiculous for me. Just hit, what? 8-1 Joseph Parker, Anthony Joshua? Are you kidding me? So I did that. But I don't bet. You know, but I will look at the odds. The odds for Anthony Joshua for Alexander Povetkin, and I repeat, are still 9-1, right? So it's not even close. They don't consider it close. If this was, people would thought this was going to be a close fight, do you know everybody, those odds would have went down? Because people were like, man, let me hurry up. But what, 9-1? What? I could get 100, get almost 1,000 from $100 betting on Povetkin? That's ridiculous. It's not happening, right? Because I already bet that was, what, about a month and a half ago when it was still 9-1 odds. It's still 9-1 odds, right? A month before the fight. So, there's telling you, somebody don't think it's this close. You know, they think close fights. You want to see the one that's directly the one that's overshadowing it? It's even with Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder. Right? Shoot, Canelo and Gennady Golovkin, pretty much even. Sean Porter and your boy Danny Garcia, pretty much even. Everybody, Callum Smith and George Groves, pretty much even. The only ridiculous fight coming up are those mismatches like Amir Khan and Vargas. That's 10-1. Other than that, fights are close. If it's 9-1, that's considered a mismatch, right? That's what the bookies say. So if you think it's like that, then you should be, I've already turned this off and be on the way bookie or clicking somewhere else, you know, getting your bet on, right? Because 9-1, okay, for Joshua or against Alexander Povetkin, however you want to say it. So that's why I don't think that fight is going to be close either, right? You know, like I said, I'm going to dinner anyway, but I mean, I don't think it's going to be a close fight. I think Joshua should handle this pretty easily. He seems to be losing some weight. Who knows why? It could be the same reason Canelo's losing weight. But he's losing weight. Maybe he's working on his quickness or something like that. So if he's even quicker, but still big enough, he's going to be taller. I think it's going to be hard for Alexander Povetkin to get on the inside. But then again, this is Povetkin. You know, it's Povetkin. Let's see what happens. But like I said, a guy's not haven't been juicing his system. You know, all of a sudden it's not there, then certain things that used to be there are not. And I'm expecting that. And I think that's what the bookies are thinking, too. Because 9-1 odds is kind of like ridiculous. That's a mismatch. Go look for an odds, guys. Fights that we think are pretty close are never like 9-1. So that means their bookies don't even think this is going to be pretty close. So, and I semi-agree. Dover Sports Talk, worldwide. And I'm about to hear y'all.